Om Namah Shivaya students, this is Tulika ma'am. In the last video of the chapter acid, bases and salt, we have learnt about the Arrhenius concept of acid and bases. According to Arrhenius, acids are those substances which dissociate to form H plus ions in aqueous solution, and bases are those substances which dissociate to form OH minus ions in aqueous solution. I am using the term aqueous solution and dissociate again and again. Remember, they show their acid shows its behavior only in aqueous solution. In the last video, we have seen an activity where there was a reaction between sodium chloride and sulfuric acid. In that reaction, HCl gas is produced. The HCl gas, which is coming out from the delivery tube, if we bring a litmus paper near it, it does not change its color. But if we bring a litmus paper which is wet or dipped in water, we will see the color changes to red. That means acid shows its behavior only in aqueous solution, according to Arrhenius. Now, on the basis of their strength, acids are classified into strong acids and weak acids. Strong acids, what do you mean by it? It completely dissociates, that is break into its ions in aqueous solution, like nitric acid, sulfuric acid, etc. And what are weak acids? Which do not dissociate into its ions completely in aqueous solution. What are bases? On the basis, according to the are also classified as strong and weak bases according to their strength. In a similar way, strong bases are those which completely dissociate in aqueous solution, like sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide. Weak bases are those which do not completely dissociate into its ions in aqueous solution, like ammonium hydroxide. So again and again I am telling, acid and bases show their behavior only in aqueous solution according to Arrhenius. Acids dissociate to from H plus ions and bases dissociate to from OH minus ions. Now suppose I give you an acid and a base, and I don't tell you which is an acid and base. I tell you, you find out which is an acid and base. How you are going to find it out? Are you going to test it? Definitely no, because they might be corrosive. So how you are going to find out whether the given solution given to you is an acid or a base? So we are going to find out with the help of indicators. What are indicators? Substances which changes its color in acidic and basic solution. Like if you add an indicator to an acidic solution or a basic solution, the color will change, and from the change in the color, we can understand whether it is an acid or a basic solution. There are three types of indicators: natural indicators, synthetic indicators and olfactory indicators. Natural indicators, we get it from natural things like turmeric, soap solution, red cabbage solution, China rose solution, litmus solution, etc. Synthetic indicators are those which are prepared artificially, like phenolphthalein, methyl orange, methyl red. And olfactory indicators, we will come to it. What are they? They are clove oil, onion and vanilla. These are also can be classified under natural indicators. Litmus. Litmus is one of the most natural chemical indicators which is commonly used. You see, there I have given a diagram of litmus which is being extracted from an organism called lichen. I have given a diagram of lichen here. From the lichen, the litmus is being extracted. The color of litmus is usually purple in distilled water. Litmus, you can get it in the form of solution as well as you can get it in the form of paper. You see, I have given a picture. You can get a red litmus paper and you can get a blue litmus paper. Litmus, it changes its color to blue when you add it to a basic solution and gives a red color when you add it to an acidic solution. So there are two types of paper you get. One is a red litmus paper and one is a blue litmus paper. If you add blue litmus paper to acid, it will change to red. And if you add a red litmus paper to a base, it will change to yellow. And a neutral solution, either the red litmus paper or the blue litmus paper will not change its color. So the solution will be a neutral solution. Now let us see the difference between acid and base on the basis of indicators. So red litmus, blue litmus, turmeric, cabbage juice, these are all natural indicators which we have discussed now. Red litmus, the original color of it is red. When you add it to an acid, that color doesn't change. But when you add it to a base, the color changes to blue. Blue litmus paper, the color is blue. When you add it to a acid, it turns red in color. And when you add it to a base, there is no change in color. Turmeric, the color is yellow. There is no change in color when acid is added to it. With base, it turns reddish brown in color. Red cabbage juice, the color is purple. When you add it to acid, it changes to reddish color, red color. And when you add it to base, the color changes to greenish yellow. Phenolphthalein, it is a synthetic indicator. The color, it is a colorless solution. When you add it to acid, it remains colorless. When you add it to base, the color turns to light pink. Methyl orange, the color is orange. When you add it to acid, it turns red in color. When you add it to base, it turns yellow in color. Onion and vanilla, these are olfactory indicators. There is no change in the smell when you add it to an acid, but as you add it to a base, the smell vanishes. Om Namah Shivaya. Thank you.